The new Callipeg update is all about flip and out-of-peg features to help you in your animation process. Let's start with the flip, available on iPad and Android tablets. You can see the new flip button here. This new flip is all about flexibility. You can start flipping here, but also anywhere on the canvas. The goal is to make it available at your finger, wherever it is. For example, if you like to keep your hand on the side of the tablet, you can flip like this, as you wish. You can access the settings of this flip button by tapping on it. You can choose between two modes, linear and circular. It can remind you the remote control you have on Callipeg Mini to control your tablet. The linear mode looks like this. It will also follow the orientation of your movement. In the settings, you also have access to other options. You can flip between sheets, frames, selected sheets, or markers. If I flip on frames, you can see here, it goes from frame to frame. To me, the most useful way is to go to sheets, so you can flip between your full drawings without having to go frame by frame. The selected sheets is a new feature here. So if I want to flip only between these sheets, I can select, tap here, selected sheets. And even if I unselect it, you can see it's visible here. It's different. It's kind of orange. And now I can flip only in this portion of the animation. And if I select another part, it will still be on this selection. So I can just go to sheets again, select another part, and go to selected sheets to flip only on this new section. And if you go fast enough before the timer ends, you can select a few like this, selected sheets, and flip only between these. The markers is self-explanatory. You can just tap marker and flip only between your markers. So if I double tap to add another marker and another one here, for example, it will flip only on my markers. I go back to sheets. The flip loop option allows you to go back to the first frame when you are at the end. So let's see here and flip to the end like that. And it will go back to the first image. The last option is go back to current frame when ending flip. By default here, if I start at frame 100 and I flip, and I end my flip at 84, it will stay at 84. But if I activate it, I start at 100 and I flip and I release the flip, it will go back to 100. So the starting point of my flip. You can also see here that I go to the right to go forward in my animation. Same way for the circular. And I can go to the settings here in the flip tab, invert flip. And now I go counterclockwise to go forward and clockwise to go back. Same for the linear. I go to the left to go forward and to the right to go back. That's as you wish, of course. I prefer to go to the normal flip. You can also move that flip button anywhere. You just have to tap and then you can slide it like this. And if you don't want to see it, you can go to the settings, flip, and disable show flip button. And now you still have access to the flip, but you don't have the button. And you can also disable the flip single finger. So if I do this, I don't have access to the flip anymore. And if I disable the flip single finger gesture, but enable the show flip button, I can flip from the button only. So I can tap, I can slide, I can flip. That way you have all the flexibility you need to use the flip feature. And of course, you can always set the sensitivity of your flip within the settings here, flip, flip sensitivity. Callipeg is available on iPads and Android tablets. It's a single purchase of 18 euros, no subscriptions. And Callipeg Mini is available on your iPhone App Store for 5 euros just once. Thanks a lot for watching. We hope that these new tools will help you in your animation process. And now start animating anywhere with Callipeg.